space where I can breathe. I believe there is a distance I have wandered to touch upon the years of reaching out and reaching.
Do you guys know when Erica's gonna be back?
Back for where?
Isn't she in her room?
No, I assumed that she was having tests taken.
Erica's having tests? For what?
Unless there's a problem.
Hey, listen, I'm gonna find a nurse. See what's going on.
I want you to take a look at these. Shots of Erica laid out so that the damage to her face is hidden.
Oh my goodness. As if she knows.
Her coat, her shoes, they're not here.
Her coat? Why would you need her coat? I mean, is she strong enough to go out?
Myrtle tells me you're looking for Erica. I checked her charts. She's not scheduled for any tests.
Well, her coat is not here, Joe.
Ah, well, there's no need for alarm. So she probably is exercising. I asked the floor nurse to check the solarium.
Joe, is she strong enough to go out alone?
No, not alone, but she'd have the assistance of staff. Because it's also possible she went to see Dr. Weiss.
Well, with the plastic surgeon, that wouldn't make any sense.
Why not? Poor darling's going to have major facial reconstruction.
The subject is off limits.
Yeah, but she's been asking a lot of questions.
Well, she's a very intelligent woman.
Yes, and everybody has made sure that they haven't said a thing about it.
Well, yeah, but it'd be just like her to, you know, take the bull by the horns and go see Doc Weiss on her own.
You know, my money's on Opal. I'll bet that's where she is. Mm-hmm.
Dr. Martin?
Yes?
I checked with Dr. Weiss. He hasn't seen Ms. Kane, and she wasn't scheduled for an appointment.
Uh-huh. Did someone check the solarium?
She's not there.
Well, thank you, nurse.
Joe, where could she be?
Joe, how could the staff not know where she is?
Oh, you know very well that if Erica Kane gets it in her mind to do something, then she does it.
Oh, dear. Well, David says sometimes that cardiac patients do have, you know, bizarre post-op symptoms.
What kind of bizarre?
What? Well, psychotic episodes.
Psychotic? What are you...
I will go and alert security.
Surgery.
Well, the staff is checking floor by floor.
Well, I'm sure Eric is going to be found before anything happens.
What could happen?
What's going on?
Eric is missing.
She's gone.
In a drive-by.
It's news. This woman's life. Exactly. Scarred for life vanishes. WRCW cannot be shut out on this.
I know. Bottom line's the bottom line. But Eric is teetering right on the edge. If word gets out now of her disappearance, it could be a panic. Her stockholders will jump ship, and Erica will crash right along with Enchantment, psychologically and physically.
I just think that we need to let people know. If the public sees her, maybe they can stop her before something bad happens.
Give us a little more time to locate her. Lights and camera are not what she needs right now.
Well, somebody's going to get the story, and maybe somebody a lot less sympathetic.
I can see why RCW is in the black. You're good.
I'm the best.
1 hour, please.
Or what?
Or I will circulate photos of you going...
You're the best. And you got it, 1 hour.
Thanks. I'm going by the Enchantment office.
Yes, Joe.
Has anybody gotten any news to David?
No, he's still in surgery. I did, however, just speak to a nurse who says she definitely saw Erica getting into a cab in the employee's parking lot. Security is checking and calling the cab company.
Well, meanwhile, I'm going to get word to David.
I'll be in my office if anybody hears anything.
Thank you.
Any news?
I have called and called, and there's no reply.
Well, maybe Erica didn't take her cell phone this
time. Well, honey, that's more trouble. I mean, Erica doesn't go anywhere without that phone.
Well, she just would not let us down, Mert.
I've been racking my brains to think, where could she have gone? You know, if I had ever had a little girl, you know, the first time I saw Erica, she was so little and so beautiful. She took my breath away. Mm. Those sparkling eyes and that radiant smile. She was vulnerable and fragile, you know. Mm. But when those eyes began to flash fire, you knew that little beauty had a will of iron.
Yeah, she's a strong one, all right.
You know, I thought if she survived her mother's death, she could survive anything.
You're just about the closest friend that Mona had, weren't you?
Yeah. Yeah, we were close. Oh, Mona. She used to worry so about Erica. She asked me to keep an eye on her, and she... I've got it.
What?
I know where Erica is. I know where she's gone. Eat.
I'm waiting to hear from the cab company.
Dimitri, did you check Erica's houses? She could be in the dark somewhere in a bedroom.
I did a room-to-room check. There was no sign that she'd even been there.
Listen, I know where Erica is. She's at home.
But Dimitri already checked London.
No. Where she was brought up. She's at home. Mona's.
Didn't they sell that house?
No, she couldn't bear to sell it.
You know, she rented it out. There are people living there.
Well, they might not be in town.
That was the cab company. The driver who picked Erica up says he dropped her at 20 Adams Street.
That's Dr. Tyler's old house. I knew it. Erica's at Mona's.
Let's go.
Oh, thank you for saving this mother.
David.
What the hell are you doing in my office? Get out.
Oh, so polite. Shame I still can't write letters to your headmaster. Yeah, well. Fine. If you don't wish to know what's happened to your patient, Erica Kane, too bad.
Get back over here.
Rudeness is one thing, my dear, but I will not be spoken to like a servant, especially a servant who's just displeased his master.
Displeased doesn't begin to describe it, Mother.
And I find the tone of your voice totally inappropriate.
I don't care whether you like the tone of my voice. Now, what about Erica?
She's missing. She's not in her room. No one can find her.
Well, did they check the other floors?
She's not in the hospital. Some of her friends think that she might have done something foolish.
You. What did you do?
Erica! Erica, you here?